Hi there everybody, Jess here from Plant Powered Yoga. Thank you so much for joining me again today for our last April free yoga session. There'll be plenty more of these in the future, but this is the last one for this month. So thank you for joining me and thank you for watching the last couple of weeks. I have a bit of a sore throat today, so apologies if my voice is a little bit croaky, which also goes into the theme of today's class. But before I go into that, I did just want to say, if you had any yoga props at home or any other things, we're going to be maybe using some of these today. If you do have a yoga block in your house, your wherever you might be, feel free to grab one. We might be using these a little bit later. If you don't have a block, we can improvise with some other things. You can also grab a blanket. So if you have a blanket rolling around, it's not many blankets left in my house that my cats haven't slept on, so this is a fur-free one, which I'm excited about using. And if you don't have a blanket, you can also use a folded-up jacket or jumper. So we can improvise with a few things. So we're going to be doing some work into our hips, so if you need a little bit of extra padding underneath, if your hips aren't as open as they would like to be, we can improvise by using some soft clothes or blankets. So I'll give you a few moments, just if you do have one of those you want to run and grab, you can go and grab those and just place them near your mat. But going back to the theme of today's class, so as I said, I'm not feeling the best today. I've got a little bit of a head cold, nothing serious, but just not feeling 100% myself. And I thought about the prospect of cancelling today's class. I thought, oh, Miriam, it's easier to just cancel. I'm not feeling very well. I don't want to do it. I can just stay in bed, or I can just lounge about. I can watch some Netflix and not do a lot today. But one of the most important things I learned on my yoga teacher training was that doing yoga and practicing yoga on your mat is a really safe place to practice life. And it really reiterated to me that yoga is just about showing up. So for those days when we're not feeling our best, or for those days when we don't feel like we're good enough, or that we're comparing ourselves to other people, that's the most important time for you to show up to yoga. The days where you're feeling great, the days where you're feeling amazingly flexible and strong, those days are also great to show up to yoga, but they're not where we really learn a lot about ourselves. And without going into too much woohoo here, I just really wanted to talk about that showing up to your mat on the days where you don't feel like you're maybe worthy enough or good enough, or you're not feeling great, they're the days that yoga is actually really important for you, and the times when yoga will help you so much more in your life. So without further ado, I will get going, because otherwise my voice will eventually start to crack. So we're going to start lying down on our backs. Is coming down to rest, and you can have your feet about hip width apart with your knees facing towards the ceiling, or you can bring your soles of your feet to touch for our Supta Baddha Konasana, so our reclining butterfly. This is a really beautiful hip opening stretch, so if it is super uncomfortable for you, you can just bring your knees back to center, or you can also take your feet a little bit wider on the mat and just have your knees knock in together. I just want to start in a really nice restorative pose. Just taking a moment to calm yourself, calm your mind, calm your body. And bring your left hand to your heart and your right hand to your belly. Just start to feel your breath moving through your body. Filling up the belly, and then filling up the chest. See if you can make it a smooth transition. Inhaling and lifting the belly,
puffing out the chest with a gentle pause at the top before exhaling out through the chest, and then the belly deflates. A small pause at the bottom. And just bring your hands into your heart center, so into Anjali Mudra, which is where our palms touch, our thumbs are pressing into our sternum. And just start with a clearing breath. So take a deep inhale. And then exhale, side out through the mouth, letting everything go. Bring your hands down beside you. Bringing your knees up, just being careful with your knees, bringing them up slowly if you have them out in your reclining butterfly. Just bringing your knees into your chest, giving yourself a little squeeze. Okay, bringing your head up to meet your knees, giving yourself a little rock. Firing up the internal organs. Coming back down, straightening the left leg. Bringing the right knee into the chest and just squeezing it there just for a moment, flexing the toe. And then starting to circle the right hip. So you might just take it in the right hand, bring the left hand to the left hip to keep it stable. And just start circling the hip in the joint, getting some blood flow to the area. And then circling around in the opposite direction. Taking it nice and wide. And then bringing it back to center, straightening the right leg, interlacing your fingers behind your thigh. So our shoulders are still on the ground. Straightening into that right leg, warming up the hamstrings. Maybe just pointing and flexing the toe a few times. Then bringing that knee back into the chest, taking hold of the right knee with the left hand and rolling over to the left, looking towards the right fingertips. Seeing the breath change, feeling it move into the side body. And then inhaling that knee back into your chest, squeezing it in one last time, and letting go slowly. Readjusting yourself on your mat if you feel like you got a little bit off angle, bringing the left knee into the chest, flexing the left toes and the right toes, really squeezing it in. And then starting to circle that hip. Maybe pressing into the right hip with your right hand to keep your body stable so we don't fall over. Just lubricating our hip joints. And then going the other way. Bringing that knee into the chest, straightening the left leg, interlacing the hands behind the hamstring, flexing the toes. It's okay if the knee is bent. And then just pointing, flexing the left foot. Just some gentle movement, really subtle, can help warm up the body. And then bringing the knee into the chest, taking hold of the left knee with the right hand, taking it across the body and looking towards the left fingertips. inhale, bringing that knee back to the chest, letting it go, straightening out the legs, bringing both knees into the chest, taking the right foot across the left knee, so we're in our figure four, and then this might be enough for you, so you should feel a nice stretch in the outer hip. If you'd like a little bit more, you can start to bring the knees closer to the chest. And you can either reach underneath your knee and towards your thigh, or you can reach across and grab your shin. Trying to keep both our shoulders on the ground so we're not lifting up. This isn't about trying to reach a point that feels unattainable or listening to our ego telling us we need to do something more. Just working with what your body can do. And then lowering down the left foot and crossing the right, and then taking the left foot over the right knee. Coming into figure four on the left side. And this might be enough, but if you like to take a little bit further, reaching for where's comfortable, trying to make sure we do the same thing of what we did on the other side. So our bodies aren't symmetrical, but it is nice to just making sure that we are trying to give a little bit of a quality to our body and not overstretching or understretching on one side. A couple of breaths here. Lowering down that right foot and crossing the left. Bring the knees to the chest. And we're just going to rock and roll. Just a couple of times. Warm up spine. Up and over onto our hands and our knees. Just finding a comfortable spot on your mat. Our toes are untucked and pressing into the mat. Our fingers are spread nice and wide. So really just take your hands nice and wide, press them into the mat. Our wrists are underneath our shoulders and our knees are underneath our hips. We're going to inhale and lift our right knee towards our nose. And exhale, slowly bring that foot out straight behind us. Inhaling slowly, bring that knee to nose. As we exhale, slowly take it out behind us. Do this three more times in your own breath. Moving slower than you think you should. And then when you've finished your fifth one, bring that knee back down. We'll swap over to the other side. Inhale, bring the left knee towards your nose. Exhale, straightening it out behind you. Inhaling slowly. Exhaling at a not quite a snail's pace. Maybe a little bit of a fast now. Three more times in your own breath. And then when you finish your last one, bringing that knee down, taking the knees nice and wide on your mat, pushing back into our child's pose. So it's letting the forehead rest on the ground. The arms are out long,
inhaling to look up towards your fingers,
coming back into our tabletop. Inhaling the right knee to nose, exhaling it out behind us. And as we inhale, we're going to bring that foot all the way in between our hands, nice and slowly, trying to do it as silently as we can. And then if you'd like a bit of an additional stretch in your front body, just tucking the toes and kind of swiveling back the left knee. And then we're going to come up into our low lunge, just for a moment, resting our hands on our right knee. And then taking an inhale as we lift the arms to the sky. Really pressing into that front foot. It's easy here to feel like we can bend nice and deeply into this, which feels amazing on our hip flexors, but it's not doing anything to engage this muscle here. So really pushing into that foot and engaging your quads. And you still feel a lovely stretch in your hip flexor. As we inhale, I'm going to open up to a Warrior Two variation. So Warrior Two, where we're still on our knees. Arms are strong. There's still a lot of strength in that front leg, keeping us balanced. Inhale, start to windmill your arms back. So your hand will touch maybe your thigh, maybe your calf muscle, or maybe even your ankle for our variation of our reverse warrior. And then cartwheeling the hands down, keeping the left hand on the ground, I'm going to twist open to the right. For a simple twist. And then bringing that hand down, starting to walk the foot out towards the edge of your mat. So the right foot is going to reach towards the edge of your mat, and your hands will be inside your feet. As we inhale, we're going to lean back and straighten that front leg. It's okay if you need to lift up a little bit more in your fingertips here. As we exhale, we're going to lean forward. Deep stretch into the hips. Inhaling back, straightening that leg. Exhaling, coming forward. Inhale once more to the back. Flex those toes. And exhale, coming forward and keeping the hands on the inside of the feet. And we're going to come into our lizard variation, and that might just be where your feet are right here. This might be enough, really sticking those back toes into the ground. You can either stay here with your knee nice and close to your elbow or your shoulder, or you can start to come out onto the edge of your foot and let the knee rotate out. Just do whatever your body's calling for today. Might take a few little rocks or movements. Sometimes in yoga we feel like we need to be so still and we can't move, and our breath needs to be perfect. But reality is that life isn't perfect, and we have to maybe adjust or move things around when we're not comfortable in a situation. Really pressing through the hands. And then bringing the foot back. So we're gonna walk it back in between our hands. So both our hands are on the outside of our foot. We can tuck the toes for a bit of extra leverage here. Come up onto the fingertips and just take the foot back to your tabletop. And then we're going to come over to the other side. So bringing the left knee into the nose. Exhaling it out straight. As we inhale, bringing that foot nice and under, underneath the shoulders, in between our hands. And picking up the right toes and just swiveling that foot back if you want to do a bit of an extra stretch into your right hip flexor. And really pressing into that front foot, coming up into our low lunge. Our hands are just on our knee for the moment. Being careful not to fall into this pose. So we want our core to be nice and strong. So when we let that go, that's when we start to fall in and becomes a bit of a lazy pose. So if we really switch on our belly muscles and we let our tailbone tuck, the big toe on the back is pressing into the ground. We're going to inhale, lift the arms to the sky. Relaxing the shoulders. Okay, if we lose our balance a little bit. And then as we inhale, I'm going to open up to our warrior two, facing towards the right this time. Keeping that front leg nice and strong. There's energy through our fingertips. And then inhaling, cartwheeling the arms back. Your hand might touch your thigh, your calf, or your ankle. And really keeping a nice bend in that front knee for our reverse warrior variation. Breathing here. And exhaling, cartwheeling those hands down. The right hand is going to stay on the ground and we're going to lift open towards the left. And then bringing that hand down, bringing the hand in between the feet or in on the other side of the foot and walking the foot out to the left side of your mat. The big toes on the right foot are pressing into the ground. And this is our lizard variation. So we're going to inhale and press back. Our hands might move. We might come up onto our fingertips as we get a deep stretch into our hamstrings. And then exhale forward. Inhaling back. Exhaling forward. One last time, inhale back, really flex those toes, feel a nice stretch into the hamstring. Coming forward. And then maybe staying here, or you can start to rotate out onto the knife edge of your foot. And you'll feel the stretch move on the inner groin and then also out to the edge of the hip. It's a lovely stretch if you sit in an office or sit in a chair for a lot of the day. And just keeping a tiny bend in the elbows. We can tend to hyperextend our elbows here because we're really pushing into the ground. But just keeping a soft bend in the elbows as you press into the ground. And then bringing that foot back, walking it in between the hands. Tucking the toes on the right foot, coming up onto the fingertips and sweeping that foot back to our tabletop. And here is where you'd maybe like to grab a prop. So we're going to come into pigeon pose, which can be quite a deep hip opener for a lot of people. And if we do a lot of sitting and we don't get a lot of rotation of hips, it can be quite painful, and I don't want it to be painful for you. So we can do some variations, but this is where it's nice to either have a block or your blanket or your jumper. So I'll show you how you can use your jumper underneath because the
There's going to be a lot of times if we want to practice yoga somewhere that we might not have a blanket or a yoga block. We'll probably have a nice comfy jumper though. So coming back into our tabletop, bring the right knee to the nose and then the right foot will come underneath in between our hands. And maybe just picking up that left knee again, taking it back. This time walking the foot over to the left side of the mat. I'm going to start to lower down that right knee to the ground. So I have a very tight hamstring and a tight psoas muscle on my right side. So for me, pigeon pose on my right side is quite difficult to sit in like this. I'm very highly elevated, which is okay. That's where our props can come into handy. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring my foot a little bit closer to my groin. So the idea with pigeon is that eventually one day we'll all have our shins parallel to the top of our mat. But like a lot of things in yoga, that just takes practice. So I'm going to bring my jumper underneath my right hip. And that's going to form a little bit of a cushion for me to sink into. So rather than my hip feeling like it's stuck in space, I'm going to keep my toes flexed and that will protect my knee. And just looking back at our left leg, looking that it's nice and straight. We're up on our fingertips. And we can stay here, we can start to lower our body to the ground. This can make the pose more restorative than sitting upright. You might come into your forearms. And just being mindful that as good as it is to have your prop there, just not sinking into it, that we're then coming up off this hip here. So we want to make sure our hips are even. So the prop is just there as a gentle support, not as a way to alter the pose. Take three more deep breaths here. Really feel the breath travel to your right hip. And then just starting slowly to come back up. Just walking your hands back, sitting up, removing any props you had out from underneath your hip. Just rolling onto that hip, bringing that foot in and then coming back into tabletop. Not the most glamorous way, but we'll get there. And then coming to the other side, so the left knee will come into the nose and bring that foot in between the hands. Picking up that right foot and right knee, taking it back. And then walking that foot across to the right side of the mat and starting to lower that knee down. I'm a little bit more open on this side and you might find that you'll be open on different sides of the body. But again, I'm just going to take my jumper, place it underneath my left hip. I'm going to keep my toe flexed on my left foot. And just take a look back at that right foot. Make sure it's nice and straight. Make sure those toes are pressing into the ground. Lifting up. And then starting to walk down slowly. Let your forearms rest to the ground. If you did so on the other side, you might even take your arms out way in front of you and let your forehead rest to the ground.
Just really try and get the breath to travel deep into that hip. So see if you can direct your breath into that left hip. Just three more deep breaths here. And then slowly starting to walk your hands back towards your legs. Taking out the prop from underneath you, if you had one. Just rolling over onto that left hip. And this time bringing the right leg around. I'm just going to come and finish in a seat. So just getting yourself comfortable. If you do have a prop there, you might like to sit on it just for a little bit of extra elevation. I'll just finish resting in a seated position today. Closing the eyes, keeping the palms face down on your legs if you would like to feel more grounded, or you can turn your palms up if you'd like to feel a bit more openness in your day. If you have your palms open, bring your forefinger and your thumb to touch for a little bit of extra connection. Breathing into the belly. Keeping the eyes closed, just bring your hands into Anjali Mudra, so into our heart center. Our thumbs maybe pressing into our sternum. And as always, I'd like to end with a beautiful quote I found from Jason Crandell that says that yoga is the perfect opportunity to be curious about who you are. And with this, we'll take one last clearing breath together. So inhaling through the nose. Exhaling side up through the mouth. Just bow your head gently towards your hands. In gratitude of yourself, the space in which you are practicing, and our ability to practice this afternoon. Thank you so much for joining me. I hope you feel as calm as I do right now. I'm probably going to go back to bed. I'm sorry if you have to go back to your office at all. But thank you so much, everyone, for joining in these last couple of weeks. I hope you got something out of each and every class that we did that was a little bit different for all of us. I just thought it was a nice way to end the month and end these classes with a nice restorative session. So I hope you feel nice and calm, your hips maybe feel a little bit juicier, and yeah, if maybe today you're a bit like me and you weren't feeling your best but you still showed up and practiced anyway, that's really a really powerful thing to do, so you should be incredibly proud of yourself if you did. But thank you so much. Stay tuned for maybe some more Facebook Lives coming up. I will be traveling later next month, so hope to do a few of these on the road for you to show you that yes, yoga can be done everywhere. So thank you so much and have a lovely day.